Hi everyone, welcome to Verbal Ability Training Module. Today we are going to learn about active and passive voice. So everyone, do you know what are active and passive voice? See, voice shows the influence of subject over the object and vice versa. That means if the influence of subject is over the object, the voice is called active, and if the influence of object is over the subject, the voice is called passive. Right? That means active voice means that a sentence has a subject that acts upon its verb, and passive voice means that a subject is a recipient of a verb's action. Now let us learn about active voice in detail. When the subject of a sentence performs the verb's action, we say that the sentence is in active voice. Sentences in the active voice have a strong, direct and clear tone. Here are some short and straightforward examples of active voice. Let us have a look at the examples. Monkeys adore bananas. The cashier counted the money. The dog chased the squirrel. All the three sentences have a basic active voice construction, which is subject plus verb plus object. Now let us talk about passive voice. A sentence is in the passive voice when the subject is acted on by the verb. For example, bananas are adored by monkeys. The money was counted by the cashier. The squirrel was chased by the dog. The active sentence consists of subject, right, verb and then object. While in the passive voice, the sentence formation consists of object plus past participle form of verb plus preposition by plus subject. Now let us learn when to use active and passive voice. Using the active voice conveys a strong, clear tone, and the passive voice is subtler and weaker. There are times when the passive voice is useful and called for. For example, let us consider this sentence. The squirrel was chased by the dog. This kind of sentence construction is helpful if a squirrel is the focus of your writing and not the dog. Now, let us learn about the rules for all tenses in active and passive voice. Students, we do not change the tense in passive voice, but we have different sets of rules in passive voice. Right? So, let us go through them. Let us learn about present indefinite tense, which is also called simple present. In active voice, we have got the set of rules as they are in tenses. When we turn a sentence from active to passive, we place object first, right? We interchange the subjects and object. Then in passive voice, the sentence construction would be as object plus helping verb plus past participle of the verb, which is also called third form of the verb, and then preposition by, and then subject, right? For negative sentences, we use object plus helping verb plus not plus third form of the verb plus preposition by plus subject. Students, if we have to make any sentence interrogative, what do we do? We use helping verb before the subject, right? So in passive voice, we use object as our subject. So the sentence construction for interrogative sentence would be as helping verb plus object plus third form of the verb plus preposition by plus subject. Let us have a look at the sentences. He reads a novel. A novel is read by him. He doesn't cook food. Food is not cooked by him. Does he purchase books? Are books purchased by him? They grow plants. Plants are grown by them. She teaches me, I am taught by her. Now let us have a look at past indefinite tense, which is also called simple past. In active voice, the sentence formation would be as it is in tenses. And in passive voice, again, we just change the helping verbs. So in past indefinite tense, we have helping verbs for in passive voice. We have was and were as helping verbs in passive voice. In simple past tense. So we will use was were in place of second form of the verb, because in tenses we use second form of the verb, right? And when we are making a sentence passive, we have to use object plus was were plus past participle form of the verb plus preposition by and then subject, right? For negative sentences you will use object, then helping verb, then not, then third form of the verb, then by and then subject. In case of interrogative sentence you will use helping verb, which are was and were in simple past tense before the object. Let us consider these examples. Rima cleaned the floor. The floor was cleaned by Rima. Aisha bought a bicycle. A bicycle was bought by Aisha. Naman called my friends. My friends were called by Naman. I saved him. He was saved by me. Now let us talk about simple future tense, right? In active voice, we have helping verbs will and shall. With I and we use shall when there is no certainty of action. And we use will with I and we also if there is certainty of action. So in passive voice, we use will plus be plus third form of the verb plus by plus subject. Everyone, be and have are the two frequently used verbs in English language, right? So in negative sentences, we will use object plus will plus not plus be plus third form of the verb and then subject. In interrogative sentences, we will use will before the object, then be, then past participle form of the verb, then preposition and then subject. Kriya will sew the bag. The bag will be sewed by Kriya. Disha will not arrange the things. The things will not be arranged by Disha. Will you mop the floor? Will the floor be mopped by you? They will post the letter. The letter will be posted by them. Now let us talk about past continuous tense. Past continuous tense is also called present continuous tense. Present continuous tense is also called present progressive tense. So in the active voice we have the same set of rules as it is in tenses, like we use is, are, am plus first form of the verb plus ing and then object. In passive voice we use object plus is, are, am plus being, because ing which we use in first form of the verb that has been shifted to be. Be plus ing equals to being, right? So we can see that here we in future indefinite we were using be to use third form after it, while in present continuous tense we are shifting that ing to be and it becomes being. So you can see that be is being frequently used in active and passive voice, right? So in passive voice, in present continuous tense, the sentence formation would be as object plus is, am, are plus being plus third form of the verb plus by plus subject. In negative sentences, we use object, then helping verb, then not, then being, then third form of the verb, then by, and then subject. In case of interrogative sentence, we use is, am, are plus object plus third form of the verb plus by plus subject in present continuous tense. Now let us consider some examples. Isha is singing a song. A song is being sung by Isha. Kritika is not chopping vegetables. Vegetables are not being chopped by Kritika. Is Ritika buying a table? Is a table being bought by Ritika? They are serving poor people. Poor people are being served by them. Now we are going to discuss past continuous tense. In past continuous tense, in active voice, we are using the same helping verbs. Subject plus was verb plus first form of the verb plus ing plus object. While in passive voice, in past continuous tense, we use the same helping verbs, was and were. But because the ing which we use in the first form has to be shifted, we again use being, right? So in simple sentence, the sentence construction in passive voice in past continuous tense would be as object plus was were plus being plus third form of the verb plus preposition by and then subject. In interrogative sentences, we will use was and were before the object, then being, then third form of the verb, then by, and then subject. In negative sentences, we will use object, then was, were, then not, then being, third form of the verb, and then by, and then subject. Like, Nitika was painting the wall was being painted by Nitika. Manish was repairing the car was being repaired by Manish. Were you reciting the poem? Was the poem being recited by you? Right? Everyone, there is no passive formation in future continuous tense. Now let us come to present perfect tense. In present perfect tense, in active voice, we have helping verbs has and have. Everyone, whenever we use has and have as helping verbs, we always take past participle form with it. Right? So, in passive voice, what you do? The helping verbs would be same as has and have in passive voice too, but you will use been after that. So, object plus has have plus been plus third form of the verb plus preposition by and then subject. In negative sentences, you use object plus has have plus not plus been plus third form of the verb plus by and then subject. In interrogative sentences, we use has have before the object, then been, then third form of the verb, then by, and then subject. Let us go through these sentences. Nitesh has challenged her. She has been challenged by Nitesh. Radhika has not written an article. An article has not been written by Radhika. Have they left the apartment? Has the apartment been left by them? Now, let us come to past perfect. In past perfect, in active voice, we use had plus third form of the verb. In passive voice, we will use the same helping verb, had, but we will take been with it. Right? Then in simple sentence, the sentence construction would be object plus had plus been plus third form of the verb plus preposition by and then subject. In negative sentences, we will use object plus had plus not plus been plus third form of the verb plus preposition by and then subject. In interrogative sentences, we will use had plus object plus been plus third form of the verb plus by plus subject. Like, we can see in the sentences, Misha had cleaned the floor had been cleaned by Misha. Vidhi had not received the parcel had not been received by Vidhi. Vishal had solved the doubt had been solved by Vishal. In future perfect, in active voice, we use subject plus will plus have plus third form of the verb and then object. In passive, we will use the same helping verb, will and shall. But in simple sentences, the sentence construction would be object plus will plus have plus been and then third form of the verb, then by and then subject. Right? In negative sentences, we will use object plus will plus have plus not plus been plus third form of the verb and then subject. In interrogative sentences, we use will, shall, then object, then have, then been, then third form of the verb, then by and then subject. Let us go through these examples. They will have brought the toy. The toy will have been brought by them. Nimesh will not have changed the table cover. The table cover will not have been changed by Nimesh. Will she have written the notes? Will the notes have been written by her? Everyone, one thing is very important to know. There is no passive formation of present perfect continuous tense, past perfect continuous tense, future perfect continuous tense and future continuous tense. Thus, we have 8 tenses in passive voice. And intransitive verbs cannot be converted to passive voice. You know why? Because a transitive verb is the verb that needs an object, right? And to make a sentence passive, we need to have object. Otherwise, we cannot change a sentence into passive voice, right? And intransitive verbs are those verbs which do not require an object. That's why if it is an intransitive verb, you cannot turn it into passive voice. Hope You have understood active and passive voice well. Thank you.